Hello, welcome to Dr. Sfau. And in today's video, we're going to be addressing a lot of medical myths with Dr. Mlenga. Dr. Mlenga, how are you doing today?
Very, very fine, indeed.
Doc, first things first, I think in this particular video, we're going to be covering maybe about 8 or 9 topics. And the first one being organ enlargement. Does this really work?
Organ enlargement.
Yes, we see a lot of advertisements for organ enlargement. Right. Does this work?
Like penile enlargement, right?
Exactly.
And breast feminine.
Exactly.
Hip enlargement.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So things work?
It's the fastest way to become poor. To believe in that kind of things. In the first place, anyone who is claiming that when you take a certain herb or tablet, your genital organ will enlarge, or your hips will enlarge, or your breast will be firm, needs to put that herb on his fingers, right? Or on the arm or leg, and see if the leg will be enlarged, or finger will be enlarged. If it won't, why use it? No, such kind of things do not work.
There's another really common myth, especially in our country, where people take Coca-Cola and Panadol to forcefully try and induce an abortion. We had talked about this in our previous video when we were covering abortion, which we'll also link that video in the description below in case you want to watch that. What's your take on people trying to, maybe let's just revisit it quickly, on people trying to use Coca-Cola and Panadol?
It cannot work. What is Coca-Cola? Coca-Cola is just sugar, okay, in water, concentrated sugar. Panadol is a painkiller. You mix the two, you get sugar and painkiller. So, no, it doesn't work.
All right, interesting stuff. Now, before I go on, I just want to remind our viewers that please be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel. We also have a Facebook group with over 31,000 members. I'll link that group in the description below. But for now, click that subscription button. It's free of charge. Subscribing is free of charge to a YouTube channel. You won't get charged anything. So yeah, make sure you subscribe to the channel. And moving on. Okay, I've also come across a lot of people saying lemon helps reduce weight.
That's a nice one. I also remember one of my cousins trying to preach to me about how he managed to put down his weight using lemon. But the truth is, what is lemon? It's vitamin C.
Exactly.
Right? The best you can say, probably improving of immunity, vitamin C, healing of wounds, otherwise weight reduction. No.
Now, while we're on the topic of weight reduction, what about tablets for weight reduction? Do those work? If lemon doesn't work, then do tablets for weight reduction work?
You find such in a lot of shops.
A lot of them,
and,
actually.
I've seen a lot of adverts say if you take this tablet 3 times, 4 times a day for a month, your weight will reduce by 15, 10, 20% or 50%. It's all a myth. Weight reduction is in 3 aspects. Your diet should be correct. The amount you eat should be correct. Your amount of exercise, burning fat, should be enhanced. That's how you reduce weight, not by tablets. It doesn't work.
Doc, when I get a headache, I drink a lot of water, and it helps me. Now, I do not know if it's a placebo or it actually really does help.
It's not only you. I've heard a lot, even in the doctor's file, there has been a lot of claims that whenever you have headache, people are being advised to take water. Now, headache has got 1,000 causes, you understand? 1,000 causes of headache. And dehydration, lack of water, is just one element, and it's not the most frequent. So no, if you have got headache, and if it's persistent, it's better to seek medical help, because the causes of headache can go up to 1,000.
Okay.
And you need to be investigated. Drinking water does not resolve anything.
What about the issue of people taking antibiotics to treat flu?
Ah, that's a very common medical myth. And unfortunately, even some health workers do give amoxicillin.
I take amoxicillin whenever I've got a flu.
Septrin when somebody has got the flu. And I've seen some patients who actually quarrel a lot if they come to you and they only go back with Panadol, you know. No, flu is a virus. It's a coronavirus, the type not the same like COVID, the one causing COVID, but it's a family of coronaviruses. Just like all viruses, they are not treated by antibiotics.
Since we're talking about flu, it leads me to go on to cough mixtures. A lot of people buy cough mixtures for coughs. I see this a lot. If a child has got a cough, the mother will go and buy a cough mixture. If I've got a cough, maybe I'll go to a pharmacy and get myself a cough mixture. Do cough mixtures actually help with coughs?
They do. They help with cough. But what the current understanding, scientific understanding, is that a cough mixture is in two forms, suppressant and expectorant. Okay, to suppress and to expect what is in the breathing apparatus. So scientifically, the current thinking is that you shouldn't have suppressed cough, all right, by cough mixtures, because the cough is a defense mechanism, meaning it is protecting you from further damage in the respiratory system. So it's trying to expel a foreign object or agent that is irritating your respiratory system. Okay? So the cough is trying to expel that. Now, if you suppress it, it means that thing will go deeper into the lungs. You've seen the thinking now.
Mm-hmm.
So we are advising people to avoid taking cough mixtures. Even expectorant, which is supposed to expel the sputum out.
All right, what about taking Piriton and Finnegan for diarrhea? A lot of people buy Piriton and Finnegan for a simple diarrhea.
In fact, I get very annoyed if that comes from a health worker. I would excuse anybody who has not done any medicine to do that. It's excusable, they don't understand. But a health worker, that's inexcusable. To go that route. So we find a lot of health workers who do that, but it is not scientifically correct.
Okay. So what does one actually do? What's the correct route if somebody does have diarrhea?
The best route for diarrhea is not use of septrin or flagyl or anything like that. We only use those antibiotics in cases where you have dysentery. Dysentery is an infection. Otherwise, general diarrhea, this one or 2 or 3 days diarrhea in a child or even an adult, just take ORS, oral rehydration salts. That's it.
Exactly. Now, lastly, Doc, vitamins and appetites. I've had issues where I've got loss of appetite and I'm told to take vitamin tablets. Does that help to increase appetite?
The use of vitamins is for those people who are not getting enough vitamins from food, like in malnutrition in children or even adult malnutrition. You supplement because they do not have enough food. The best source of vitamins is food. Vitamins do not increase your appetite, but we use it as a placebo in medical, you know.
Oh, so it's just a placebo effect.
Yeah, we use it as a placebo. We would never tell you that they don't have.
Or now they know.
Well, knowledge is power.
Knowledge is power indeed. All right, Doc. Yeah. Are there any other medical myths that you have come across that you would like to address before we wrap this video up?
I mean, for this time, I think we have flooded the people with so many of them, but that will do.
We will definitely get attacked with a lot of questions, especially in the Doctors for Our Facebook group. And thanks for watching. Please be sure to subscribe to our channel and join our Facebook group. Link is in the description below. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed. And also make sure you leave us a comment below. The doctor will definitely address your questions every single time. All right. Thanks for watching and we'll see you in the next one.